Today's feast in honor of St. Bartholomew, also originally known as the Apostle Nathaniel, is a little bit difficult because we don't know much about the life of Nathaniel or Bartholomew. This is really the one time that he is mentioned in the scriptures. So in this gospel, we hear how Philip the Apostle went and told Nathaniel, who may have been a disciple of John the Baptist originally. He tells Nathaniel, "We have found the one whom Moses spoke about in the law." So already Philip was forming in his mind a connection between Jesus and the law of Moses. This is kind of an advanced way of looking at Jesus already. So he comes to Nathaniel and wants to share the good news. "Come and see the guy who we think is the one who is promised, is Jesus, the son of Joseph from Nazareth." Well, Nathaniel, of course, is very skeptical, and he says that kind of derisive comment, "Can anything good come from Nazareth?" What does Philip tell him? "Come and see." We say that sometimes. See for yourself. Philip invited Nathaniel to meet Jesus. And after his meeting with Jesus and his brief conversation, Nathaniel makes a profession of faith. He says, "You are the King of Israel. You are the Son of God." Those important words, "come and see," are repeated in various places in the Gospels. When Andrew the Apostle first met Jesus, he asked Jesus, "Where are you staying, Rabbi?" What did Jesus say? "Come and see." And he became an apostle. When the woman at the well, the Samaritan woman at the well, had this conversation with Jesus, what did she do? She went off and told the people, "Come and see someone who told me everything I ever did." And they became followers after they went to see Jesus. When Thomas was absent the first time the risen Christ appeared to the apostles, they most likely talked to Thomas later and said, "You have to come and see." So each of us is invited to come and see the Lord. Of course, that doesn't mean that we can see him in the flesh. We know that that's not possible yet. But we still come to see Jesus in different ways. We see him in the pages of the Bible. We see him in the sacraments, in our prayers. We see him in the life of others who are loving and compassionate. Perhaps the best invitation that we can give to others to come and see Jesus happens when we live the life of faith authentically. You know, our public lives, the way we live in the presence of others, those are very important in the sense of extending to others the opportunity to meet Christ. That opportunity to see him in us can lead a person to make a profession of faith at some point. I think it's also important to understand that our invitation to others to come and see Christ has to be welcoming and compassionate. We cannot coerce others into meeting Christ. In fact, we're not the ones who are responsible for making converts. God makes converts. When we treat other people with gentleness and love, when we forgive, when we have mercy on people, the invitation to meet Christ is offered. And after that, it becomes God's work to introduce other people to his Son. After all, God is the one who sent his Son into the world, and he is the one who introduces his Son to people who are looking to meet him. So today is a good day to pray for people who might be searching for Christ, who want to know. In a world, you know, that is confusing and morally ambiguous, people are searching for something, or rather someone, who can help them make sense of life. If we believe that we have found the person who helps us live with purpose and meaning, then we have no choice but to invite other people to come and see.